Jesus' precious blood that pours out from the sacred head of our Lord Jesus Christ, the temple of divine wisdom, tabernacle of divine knowledge, and sunshine of heaven and earth, cover us now and forevermore. Amen. There is power in the blood of Jesus. I say there is power in the blood of Jesus.
Thank you. gather his name because we believe in you. We have no place to go to. You are the Alpha, you are the Omega. You are the source of our existence. Please speak your words into us again. Fill our hearts with your words. Fill our being with your word. Fill our spirits with your word. Make us happy. Give us reason to smile. Bless our coming here today. Nourish us. Let the enemy be put to shame. Every power that has followed us to this place, working to destroy our destiny, Father, we destroy them in the name of Jesus. No one can close our chapter. For what you have written about us can be fulfilled in our lives in the name of Jesus.
This contains 200 beads.
there was helping people to say, thank you, Jesus. All you say is thank you, Jesus. 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 You go to the bread morning, say, oh, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. And I will teach you how to say. Of course, you can make it. And then you pray. It is not for God, but to be prayed. We are going to do all these things so that we get enriched spiritually. There is something that is making me move in the way I need. I'm not a holy man. I'm a saint. A saint as a sinner. Because if you are a sinner, and you see yourself as a sinner, you are a saint. If you recognize that you are a sinner, you are a saint. How many of you are sinners here? Everybody is now a sinner. And if you are a sinner, you know you are a sinner, you are a saint. Do you understand that? If you are a sinner and you know you are a sinner, you are a saint. Because the truth has set you free. You know you are a sinner, you are a saint. I don't want us to spend all the night here. All I need from you is your great attention, because God is taking you to another level.
Yeah.
Thursday, I'm going to give you facts you must know. I have that message, the truth you must know. The truth you must know. So that you don't waste your time coming here. There are certain things you must know about life. The Bible says only the truth can set you free. If you want to be a victorious Christian, you want to live a life of victory, anywhere you want, you must believe and understand this truth. And that is the first message I'm giving you here in South Africa during this revival program this year. Truth that you must know. I'm going to give you about five of them. Truth you must know. Number one, there is no prayer too hard for God to answer. There is no prayer too hard for God to answer. There is no prayer too hard for God to answer. That's number one. So, do not allow the devil to make you feel that this particular case, this issue about your life, cannot be handled through prayer. Prayer is a key that can open every door. The truth is that there is no prayer too hard for God to answer. Is somebody hearing me?
Yes.
Are you listening to me?
Yes.
Please tell your neighbor, whoever gave us ears. Put that as well. Slap whatever you gave us. See, I never.
What is the story about your life? What is the story about your family?
For you to be discouraged. The devil tells you that all hope is lost. This is your case, nothing. It's not true. That is the power of the devil, discouragement. Take it to God in prayer. For you are hearing the truth that is setting you free today, that there is no prayer that God cannot answer. If you want to go home today, you say, God, I want to leave this country. I want to go back to my people. I know this is where everywhere is blocked. When you take it to God in prayer, put it before the Lord here, God will give you a way. He says, I am in way. There is no prayer too hard for God to answer. There was a woman that had a little son, and the son died. And when he took son, sons remained for burial. And as the Lord would go, God demonstrated his power. The son came back to life. There is nothing God can do. Don't be discouraged. Please, be any man, don't be discouraged. It's a truth that you must accept. Learn to pray. No matter how short, no matter how small. Don't be deceived by these fake passports all over getting your money. You have 2,000 rands and they are there getting your 2,000 rands. They are serving you the more. Pray. Be a man of prayer. Every Christian is baptized unto prayer. You have God as your father. The reason why things are not working that way for you and for me is that we don't pray. We don't chat with God. God wants us to chat with Him. There is no prayer to have for God to answer. There is no prayer, petition you can make to God that God cannot remove. Please, I beg you. It's a true story. There is no prayer to have for God to answer. Let it enter your prayer. Let it be what, why you like that, you think about it. The man of God says today that there is no prayer to have for God to answer. Then this time, I don't think God can make money, but he says, I speak it to God in prayer, that there is no way that God cannot, no matter how difficult, how tight, how dangerous that intention is, if you learn to take it to God in prayer, he will answer. Number two, there is no enemy too hard for God to dismantle. There is no enemy too hard for God to dismantle. In this world, many people will rise against you. We have number one enemy called the devil. And we have the secondary enemy called the agents of the devil, fellow human beings, who plan for your downfall. Last time I came to London, we heard of a young man that was shot and killed in Germany. People see your clothes, they want to destroy you. People see you are making, they want to set you up. They want to ruin your life. They leak your secrets. These are enemies. Some people are holding the destinies of people. We are in Africa. We know what is in Africa. We have the black power. For this second truth says, there is no enemy too hard for God to dismantle. Say it, everybody.
He was posing as a mighty man. And he was suppressing the people of God. I don't know who
scripture that people is that we cannot fear anything. One young beautiful lady was just falling, I was screaming. The people that invited me, they closed the lid and they were hearing what she was saying. And then she said, they were calling me, I was on the phone, not there, said, no, and I'm in the field. I was praying, I was shouting, fighting, and asking people were supposed to be calling. And I went close to the little girl, beautiful girl. And she was speaking in our dialect, in Igbo dialect. Emeka, where are they? John, where are they? Peter, where are they? John, where are they? Matomi, where are they? Dibie, where are they? And what captured my attention was that she was calling the names of only boys, men, masculine name, and she was saying, where are they? Where are they? Say, where are they? She was saying, take your own. Peter, take your own. John, take your own. David, take your own. Emeka, take your own. Jerry, take your own. And that thing so captured my attention. And we placed the microphone into our mouth. And I was saying, take your own. And I went to the church. My friend said, take your own. Take your own. And the prayer became water. And when this desolate confessing, Jesus Christ, I learned something in him. For the first time in my life, according to her, she became possessed when she was very young. And because she was beautiful, the enemy used her. They placed snake into her private part. And that any man that makes love to her, we release her sperm into her body, indirectly into the mouth of the serpent. And the serpent began carrying his sperm into the kingdom, and then forming his sperm into the shrine. And as many that made love to her, that she but lost their destiny. They can never have a child, never make it alive. No matter the millions of naira they make up, it's like pouring water in the bucket, in the basket. But the prayer became so tough that she had to start releasing those people's destiny. And that was how she was saying, John, take your own. Emeka, take your own. Jesus, take your own. Was grass. Big! It was night. He could not go back to his palace. He slept in the forest. A king, just one portrait, was oppressed. And his brain changed. He became an animal. He was eating the animal's food and living in the forest. Until he came to him, God gave him the grace to realize his mistake. And he confessed and said, God is too much. And that was how he realized and confessed that this God is the ultimate. Many of us are living under fear. We are scared of our house. We are scared of our house. We are scared of witchcraft. We are scared of that man. We are scared of that woman. But there is no enemy that will come to this mansion. God can bring them. God can dismantle them. God can come their brain. And if it is true that this God can do this, why are you living a life here? If you realize that your grandmother in the village are those, and the agents of darkness are those fighting your destiny, why keep quiet? Take them to the brain. Fire them too. Neither be desperate in prayer. There is no enemy that God cannot dismantle. God is waiting on you. During this program, I challenge you. If you know of anyone, let us take them to God. If you know of anyone, if your parents call you on the phone and they said, look at them, they are putting you in your house, that is, take them to God. No matter the black power, there is no power that can challenge the power of God. Do you believe this?
Yes.
Do you believe this?
Yes.
Every environment has their own culture. Every environment walk in that environment. Shepherd, Meshach, and Abednego, they were placed into the environment of consummation, fire. It has culture. Fire has a culture. Fire burns. Having been placed in a place where they want to be burned to death. That is what people are doing. They set you up. The kingdom of darkness is set up. You say you don't know. Everything looks so natural. But you are in trouble. You are dying. You are decaying. Everything is somersaulting. This is a wicked world. But I thank God we serve the living God. He's the same yesterday and today. He's the Alpha and the Omega. And there is no environment in which this God cannot operate. Hallelujah.
Please, even though they say that we are perishing, we are dying, this and
control money, he can control even man, he can control even woman, he can control the dust, he can control the atmosphere, he can control the office, he can control the manager, he can control even the light, he can control even the chair. There is nothing that God created that he cannot control. If they want to destroy you, they will use what God created. No man can use anything that he created. If you want to be destroyed in this world, no human being created anything. And God who created this flower can control this flower. God who created Father Mario can control Father Mario. So when you now want to pray as a believer, and you are under environment that are not conducive, know that whatever the world is against you, God can control them. They have not created it. You are born to live a victorious life. You are born to live a life of joy. Do not allow the devil to cut away your joy and cut away your peace. And you are living in anguish. You are living in pain. You are managing nonsense. Don't manage such things. Take this path and then you will be a victorious one. And the last one is, there is no sin that the blood of Jesus cannot wash away. When the devil knows you know this truth, he will use sin to fight you. He will tell you, oh, you are a killer. Oh, you are a fornicator. Oh, 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 you are a drug addict. Oh, 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 you are this. Oh, 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 you are this. Please know this now. There is no sin that the blood of Jesus cannot wash away. Are you hearing me? There is no sin. No matter how thick the stain may be, the blood of Jesus can wash them away. If you know these five truths and you put them into practice, you believe in them, you have faith in this, you will be happy. You will take it to God in prayer. And then with these five points, you can sing that song. There is something that may be coming to your presence. My heart, there is something that gets me coming to your presence. Beg all your neighbors, pot, jar, as many as you want. There is no need that God cannot provide. On Sunday, I shall be blessing you with this oil. I shall be anointing you with this oil. By this time, two things will really happen in your life. I want to say three things. I need to put it in prayer. Only two. That's happening. Two. And this is the moment when we gather the chance. And then the man of God said, "Enter your room, you go call it, people in there." She took this small prayer that was at home. Pain. Freedom. Pain. Freedom. Pain. She said to the son, "Bring more." They brought the pocket back. Pain. Freedom. They bring. Pain. Win. Pain. Win. What is happening? Who is doing this? Who is doing this magic? Pain. And the whole entire room. Freedom. With oil. The woman said, "This is what happened." She ran to the man of God and said, "Man of God, I have more than 20 gallons of oil. They are in my room. Feel." The man of God laughed and said to her, "There is no need that God cannot provide. Go! Sell it! Sell it! Pay all your debts! You will still have one left. Use it and begin a new life." That is my prayer for you at the end of this program. God declare all your debts and give you a new life. Lift up your hands and say, "Oh Lord Jesus,
7 times, plenty upon that body, and it will drive them away. Now we go. Holy Ghost.
most precious blood that pours out from the sacred head of our Lord Jesus Christ, the temple of divine wisdom, tabernacle of divine knowledge, and sunshine of heaven and earth, cover us now and forevermore. Amen.